I didn't know who was gonna be here, but I was hoping we had more coming tonight. But I tell you, we need something that will give us some boost.
Yes.
Amen.
We need something, church, that will give us, to energize us. Sometimes God's people need to be energized. We like that the battery sometimes, we run low, we need to get that battery energized, amen. So tonight I'm going to preach on tonight, going in the power of the Father. Amen, going in the power of the Father, amen. I tell you, I believe tonight that Jesus said it was expedient for me for to go away, because if I don't go away, I can't send the Comforter. My Father won't send the Comforter back. Amen, and he said, I will. And even John the Baptist said, I baptize you with water, but he is coming to baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. Amen. I tell you, for every time that we need that fire, we need it now. Amen. And the Bible tells us in the book of Acts chapter 1 there, you see the working of the Holy Ghost. Amen. In the very beginning of the church. The Bible says, the former treaties have I made. Theologians, and all that Jesus began both to do and teach until the day in which he was taken up, after that he, through the Holy Ghost, had given commandments unto the apostles whom he has chosen. Now, church, the apostles still hasn't been done away with, amen? The Holy Ghost was moved upon the apostles, and the Holy Ghost still moves upon people today, amen? Only thing is, people today are not looking for it, not wanting it, and don't realize how much they need it, amen? And so we need today, amen, to understand that when God sent us the Holy Ghost, he sent us that we could be what we need to be, that he could operate in us through his power. And the Bible says in verse 4, well, let's go back to verse 3, to whom he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God, and being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, you have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. And when they therefore came together, they asked him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom of Israel? And he said unto them, it is not for you to know the time or the season which the Father hath put in his own power, but you shall receive the power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Now Jesus had promised the disciples that he was going to have to go away, that when he was going to go away, he would tell the Father to send the Holy Ghost back, amen, in Jesus, amen. And he said that you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. The church, for every time that the church today needs the power of the Holy Ghost, it's now, because the Bible tells us, if you read the next verse, the Holy Ghost will give you power to be a witness. And for every time that we need to be a witness, I believe it's now, church, because I'm going to tell you something. The churches are falling away. Amen. The love of many are waxing cold. And I tell you, if we don't have the witness, if we don't have the power of the Holy Ghost, people today are going to be lost. And church, we see the Bible tells us in what it said, hell has enlarged itself because there's so many people turning away from God. But church, God gave us a power, amen, that we could be a witness, and we could have that anointing, and we could have that power that would cause people, amen, to stand up and take notice that Jesus is still alive, that Jesus is still working in his behalf. And for every time that we need to be a witness of that, I believe it's now. Can I hear it? Amen. Amen. Well, the Bible says in the next verse, it says, verse 8 said, but you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be a witness unto me, both in Jerusalem, in all Judea, in all Samaria, and unto the uttermost parts of the world. And church, I want us as a church, I know we don't have to be a great number. Now, church, the Bible said there was only 120 people in the upper room, and the Bible said they turned the world upside down in the way. In other words, they spread the gospel because Jesus told the disciples and told them, he said, I want you to tarry in Jerusalem. See, the people today need to tarry at church. They need to get filled with the Holy Ghost where God can send them out, amen, to be a witness unto a lost and dying world. And church, that Holy Ghost and fire will cause us to have that we can have the power to be a witness, amen, to a lost and dying world, and a witness to those that are around us, a witness to our family. Because church, if you got that anointing and that fire in your life, amen, you are going to be noticed, and you're going to be a witness unto the one that has sent the comfort down here and the power of the Holy Ghost. So we need that, church, because see, as we get filled with the Holy Ghost of power, we are going to be, I believe, like Jesus. Amen. And church, let me tell people today, the church is never trying to be like Jesus, but they don't have the anointing and they don't have the power that the Jesus had. See, Jesus had to have the Holy Ghost, and we need the Holy Ghost. I'm talking about the Holy Ghost and baptism. I'm talking about that Holy Ghost and power that's coming down from heaven. After we get saved, church, I believe God wants to turn us into a different person. The Bible teaches in the Old Testament that when Saul was anointed to be king, the Bible said that Samuel anointed him, amen, and he began to talk and speak in tongues, and the Bible says he became another man. He had that anointing, and he had that power upon him, just like Jesus. Jesus has that power. And church, we can't do the work like Jesus did, amen, unless we've got the Holy Ghost and that power and that anointing in our life. We can't be a preacher. We can't be a pastor. We just can't be a Christian as a whole to be able to show the light of Jesus until we get the witness. Amen. I talked about the Holy Ghost tonight. The Bible tells us in the book of Acts, chapter 10, verse 38. Now, church, I believe God's gift saved us. I believe he left us here that we could be like the Bible. Jesus said, I go back to the Father, and if you believe upon me, he said, greater thing that you can do than I did, because I'm going back to the Father. What he was talking about, he's going to send the Holy Ghost back to the church, and the individual will have that same anointing that Jesus had. And church, we tell you, you've got that Holy Ghost of fire, you've got the same anointing that Jesus has, and you can do the same work that Jesus did, because the Bible said that you've got the Holy Ghost of fire, you've got God's anointing, and you've got God's presence upon your life. And church, the church needs that today, because they're dying. They're drying up, and there's no joy, and there's no fire. All we have is a bunch of smoke and a bunch of promises. But church, I'm here to tell you, we get the Holy Ghost far back in church, you're going to see things happen. Just like in the New Testament, the book of Acts, we're going to see things happen. The Bible tells us in Acts 10, this is what it says, 38, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. In other words, God gave him the power and the fire, amen, to do a work that God sent him down to do. He had a job to do, church. We've got a job to do. We need to get out and be a witness to God and recognize that the world recognize that we've got Jesus and the Holy Ghost in us, and we got that power and anointing and God's presence with us. This is what it said. It says, who went about doing good, healing all those that were oppressed of the devil. The world is full of people today that are oppressed of the devil. And the reason why nothing is happening is because we don't have the Holy Ghost and power working in our minds and working in our church. And God has given this to the church that we can have what the power that he wants us to have, and the same power that Jesus had. And church, I'm here to tell you, I believe with all my heart, we get back serious with God, talk to an old-fashioned altar somewhere, and clean out your closet, and get in your closet, and begin to pray and bombard heaven, and say, Jesus, I want that power. I want the Holy Ghost back in my life. Now, church, let me tell you something. A lot of people had the Holy Ghost at one time, and I believe it's leaked out. Now, I know you've got to have the Holy Ghost to be saved, but I'm talking about the baptism of the Holy Ghost. I'm talking about when you get filled up and running over and bubble over, that amen, he will touch somebody else's life. The church, we're not having that no more. And church, we need that, because if Jesus had to have it, and the church had to have it. We've got to have it. Can I hear an amen? Amen. So we need to pray, church, and do away some of the things that's hindering us from being a Holy Ghost a person, that God could be a witness in our life. Amen. Can I hear an amen?
Amen?
Now the Bible tells us, see, He wants us to be like Him. And we'll be like Him if we get filled with the Holy Ghost. And we need to pray and seek God. Like I say, get in the closet. And get what it means is get by yourself. Where the Avon lady can't knock on the door. Or when the telephone won't ring. Get to yourself where nobody can hinder you. Amen. Can I hear an amen? Amen? And get along with God and say, now Jesus, You said that You would fill me with the Holy Ghost and power, and that He's going to send it back. And church, I believe that we get hungry for it and thirst after it and want God to work in your life. Church, let me tell you something. God will not work in a person's life that is filled for the world and everything else. The Holy Ghost comes in and purges everything out and fills that vessel up that God can use, because church, it takes a Holy Ghost-filled person. And I talk about a Holy Ghost-filled person to do the work that we need to do today. And church, the people don't have it. I don't think people desire it because it's too much of a sacrifice. But church, I'm here to tell you, I believe we begin to get the Holy Ghost and say, Lord, I want You to use me whatever it takes. I want to get filled up. I want to see the work of God that used to be done. I want to see healing. Yeah. I want to see deliverance. Yeah. I want to see my loved ones saved. Yeah. I want to see the devil cast out. I want to see the drug addict set free. I want to see the alcoholic set free. I want those that have weight and sin in their life be able to, that the Holy Ghost will purge it out. Oh, give the Lord a hand clap, church. Yeah. Glory to God. And not only that, to be like Jesus, God wants us to be a servant. Do you realize God wanted the people even to be a servant to be Holy Ghost filled?
Amen.
I looked at that desert, but I've never seen it like that. We want the Holy Ghost, but we want to do great things. But if you're looking at the Bible says in the book of Acts, chapter 6, and it do you good to read it. The Bible says that Paul was as a apostle and as a pastor of things, the Bible says, wherefore, brethren, Acts chapter 6, verse 3, wherefore, brethren, look ye out among you seven men of honest report. And what did it say? Full of the Holy Ghost. Now there's a reason why Paul said that, because church, see, the pastors they don't have time to do the work as a servant. Other words, the things that need to be done around the church and visitation on these things, that the congregation need to do that. If we're filled with the Holy Ghost, they gotta be filled with the Holy Ghost and the power of God, that they can go about and do the work, amen, with a pastor that he can pray and read God's word and feed you. But the idea of it is, they wouldn't call them to do the service and serve the tables and everything. If you look at it, God wants us to be servants for Him, but it takes a Holy Ghost filled person to even to be able to serve the tables or serve the things in the church. That's what it says now. They need to be full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business. But we will give ourselves continue to prayer and to the ministry of the word. And this saying pleased the whole multitude, and they chose Stephen, a man full of faith and of the Holy Ghost, and Philip. I want you to know they added Philip there because there's a reason there, church, because I want you to know something. It's going to take a Holy Ghost-filled person to be a servant for God. Not only do they have to wait on tables, but also to be able to serve as a minister or a worker for God. Amen. And the Bible tells us that, see, there's times that God is using people in different ways. Now, I'm going to take you from chapter 6 over to chapter 8. Now, I want you to listen to what happened in verse 5. Now, the Bible says Philip was full of the Holy Ghost too. And the Bible says in Acts chapter 8, verse 5, and Philip went down to the city of Samaria. Now, if you'll notice, they wasn't allowed to preach in Samaria until Jesus, amen, died and went to Calvary. That was because they were Gentiles in a roundabout way. And so God told the disciples not to preach at that time while he was there. But now he's gone to heaven. Now he sent back the Holy Ghost. Now Philip was told to go to Samaria by the Holy Ghost to preach the gospel there. You know who God sent? He sent a Holy Ghost man that turned to, he got filled full of the Holy Ghost. Then God sent him out there to serve tables. He got promoted from the tables, amen, to ministering the word of God. And church, let me tell you something. God wants to use everybody. He wants to use you, amen. He wants to, that you can be a witness, you can have power, you can have authority, and you can be a minister of God's word, that you can be able to set people free. Jesus come to set the captive free. He come to open up the prison. He come to heal the sick. He come to heal the blind. He come to heal those that were in captivity. That was his job. That's what he came to do, to seek and to save the lost and deliver those. But also he said, I'm going to send you. So God is sending people out, amen, to do a work for him. But we don't preach it anymore. We don't practice anymore. That's why you're not seeing miracles anymore. It's because the Holy Ghost can't do the job that he's supposed to do. He's supposed to work through us through the power of God. Now this is what he says. Then Philip went down into the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. And the people with one accord gave heed to those things which faith, first of all, Philip spake. See, he had an anointing about him. He had a power about him. And the Holy Ghost was directing him how to want to preach. Church, the Holy Ghost will direct you to preach. He'll direct you to the gifts. He'll direct you to all these things that you need to go with and understand and to be used. So the Holy Ghost was directing Philip to preach the word of God. And church, there's every time that we don't need to preach about, they preach everything but Jesus. Right. Amen. We need to preach Jesus and Him crucified, the Savior and the healer and the deliverer of us. Can I hear an amen? But they preach everything else. But the Bible says Philip went down and he began to speak. But this is what the Bible says. Hearing and seeing the miracles which he did. Now church, miracles will follow the preaching. Can I hear an amen? I said, miracles will follow the preaching. It takes the anointing preaching of God's word, amen, to cause the people to stand up and have faith and believe in Jesus. The reason why people are not getting healed today and getting delivered today is because people don't have enough power of the Holy Ghost and the direction of the Holy Ghost that they can preach what God wants them to preach and direct them into a place that they'll be able to do the miracle and see the miracle. See, God wants to do signs and wonders. He wants to use you. He wants to use me. He wants to use them. You don't have to be a preacher, and you don't have to be a Pentecostal. You can be a Baptist. You can be a Nazarene. You can be anybody that is willing to receive the Holy Ghost. If you've been saved, you are intended, amen, to have the Holy Ghost. I'm talking about speaking in tongues as the Spirit gives you the utterance, and therefore show that you've been full of the Holy Ghost and you're best to be used of God. But we've got to keep it, church. And too many church people, they have leaked out the Holy Ghost. I believe that a lot of people have a bucket, has a hole in the bucket. Amen. That Spirit leaks out. The Bible says that the apostles at one time had to go back and get a refilling because they lost their boldness. They lost their testimony. They lost all the things that they had. So they had to go back and ask God to reveal them and give them the bonus and give them the power back. Now these churches need to go back to the altar and say, God, I don't have the boldness. I don't have the joy. I don't have the peace. I don't have the righteousness. I don't have the hope, because this comes through the power of the Holy Ghost. And God, we need that in the church today, that a lost and dying world can see Jesus in us and see the miracles and see the authority that God wants to use, that he can get a world saved and get our churches full today. We don't need a bunch of programs. We don't need all these things in churches. We need to get the world out, get Jesus back in, and get the Holy Ghost back in, and you will see miracles, and you will see young people, because they are looking for something that will set them free and give them something, amen, to talk about. I'll give the Lord a hand clap. Hallelujah. When Philip began to preach, see, signs will follow the preacher. And the Bible says there, it says, and the people with one accord gave heed unto the things which Philip spake, hearing and seeing the miracles which he did. For the unclean spirits, crying with a loud voice, come out of many that were possessed with them, and many taken with palsy, Now, church, it takes a Holy Ghost filled person to be able to come against those these demon spirits. Because we're fighting against principalities and powers. And they say that over some, the darkest part of Africa, I'm talking about the Baptists and Nazarene love, were going out and asking for Pentecostal Holy Ghost filled people because the demons and the darkness were so great that they couldn't even handle the powers of darkness. So they wanted to come back to get the people that were filled with the Holy Ghost and with God's power and God's anointing to go into those dark, deep, demon places there where they could preach the gospel. And the Bible said that the people said that there were many saved and demons were cast out. And because it takes the work of the Holy Ghost, we can't do it on our own. And church, you've got to be Holy Ghost filled when you start casting out the demons.
Amen.
Amen. And it says that many of them were possessed with them, and many taken with palsy, and that there were like even the lame were healed, and there was great joy in that city. That is what the Holy Ghost would do in our lives, church.
Amen.
We get that Holy Ghost and that anointing, that fire upon us. The church people have lost their fire, church. They don't have the anointing, and that's what it represents, the anointing, the fire, the power, and the church, he will clean us up too far, and will also clean us up. And I tell you, there's a lot of people that need the Holy Ghost, that the Holy Ghost can clean their life up. Amen. God can save us. Amen. He can give us the Holy Ghost. And I'm talking about the baptism of the Holy Ghost, because you get that baptism of the Holy Ghost in you, it's going to clean you out. It's like a fire. It's like a fiery. It will clean us out, church. And all these things that will hinder us, and all the waste and all the sin in our lives, it will burn it out.
Amen.
I said it'll burn it out. Glory
Amen.
To God.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God. That's why God said he give us power.
Right.
Church, we if the church back there need the Holy Ghost, we need it now, amen.
Amen.
And I'm talking about the Holy Ghost in fire. You know what Jesus said? He said, John the Baptist said, I'll baptize you with fire. But he said, there is one coming. He will baptize you with the Holy Ghost and with fire. We need that fire, church.
Amen.
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 Churches are dead. They're dying. They have no power. They have no anointing. And we're living in a late honest church.
Right.
We're living in the Laodicean church age. But we got Jesus outside. You get Holy Ghost back in the church, you got Jesus in the church. Amen.
Amen.
Let's stand tonight.